So, put the title, Post-Colonial Literature, Post-Colonial Theories. हम बात करेंगे post-colonials की. One of the very favorite topic, one of my topics. Because this is the present time we are going through. The changes, the lifestyle that we have adopted, the lifestyle we are following, it belongs to post-colonial concepts. And when we'll discuss post-colonial literature, we'll go for post-colonial theories. वो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है. वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड थ्योरीज, लिटरेचर इज नॉट दैट टफ. सो बिफोर वी गो फॉर पोस्ट कॉलोनियल्स, आई वॉन्ट टू नो वॉट इज कॉलोनाइजेशन. एनी वन? वॉट इज कॉलोनाइजिंग समवन? कॉलोनाइजेशन. Coming from outside and controlling someone. Coming from outside and controlling someone. So we are taking the reference of Britishers. Yes, sir. What if I came from outside and I'm controlling you right now? Isn't a colonization? Isn't it? It is also a kind of colonization. Psychological colonization ye bhi hai. If I am planting my ideas in your brain, theek hai? Maybe forcefully or without force. हो सकता है आई एम फोर्सिंग यू टू फॉलो मी एंड मे बी दिस आई एम कन्विंसिंग यू टू फॉलो मी. इन बोथ केसेस आई एम कॉलोनाइजिंग योर ब्रेन. नाउ हाउ द वर्ल्ड गॉट चेंज बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉलोनाइजेशन, डीकॉलोनाइजेशन एंड वॉट इज द प्रेजेंट स्टेटस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड राइट नाउ. दैट्स द कॉन्सेप्ट हियर. लेट्स मेक इट वेरी इजी इन माई स्टाइल. वी विल गो बैक टू इंडिया ऑफ 1498. This is the India of 1498, okay? Now we know what happens in 1498. Vasco da Gama ki. So Vasco da Gama found us in 1498. India ko Vasco da Gama ne dhunda. And after this discovery, let's go for the British Raj. India in British Raj. I'm just making it easy for you so that you understand. British Raj wala India, kaun sa India hai? The India before 1498, the India during the British Raj around 200 plus years, and then the India after 1947, and then we were freed. Today we have the birthday of Mahatma Gandhi, 2 October 1869, if I'm not wrong. So India after 1947, so ye un sab logon ne, Bhagat Singh ne, sab ne milke hume azad karwaya. Bahut saare logon ne apni jaan di. So now we have three different Indias in front of you. The first one, 1498 India, totally untouched. India under British Raj, where they were having their army. They forced us to behave, they forced us to learn something according to them. And the India of 1947, after 1947, we can say 2019. Teen India hai humare paas, clear? Which is real India? Aapke according real India kya hai? How many of you have mentioned your nation as Indian in your Aadhaar card? Sare Indian ho?
Yes sir.
Pakka?
Yes sir.
Aadhaar card ke according ho ya actually Indian ho? Actually Indian kaise ho?
Aadhaar card ke according actually Indian
nahi. So that's what you have to understand. The very first thing, 1498 se pehle, India before 1498, it was something very native, very real. We can say the original thing. Then a new mindset, a new brain comes. Now the people, those who came from West, jo West se aaye, there's a new brain, new idea. The Westerns, they came to East and found that we people are the savages, tribals, illiterates. अब जो बाहर से आए उन्हें पता चला कि तो गंवार है, इन्हें कुछ नहीं आता है. एंड दे डिसाइडेड दैट वी विल टीच देम, वी विल अपग्रेड देम. और अपग्रेड करके क्या बनाएंगे? अपने जैसा. द ब्रिटिशर्स दे थॉट दैट विल अपग्रेड देम, विल मेक देम लाइक अस. And from this idea, the concept develops us other mentality. The post-colonial concept of us other mentality. Us other mentality has been developed by Edward Said. Ji, he wrote Orientalism in 1978. Please mention that. बेसिक समझ लो, उसके बाद आपको थ्योरीज एक एक समझ में आनी शुरू हो जाएंगी. हाँ, सीट्स ले लीजिएगा, आगे भी कुछ है, इधर एडजस्ट करके सीट्स मिल जाएंगी. सो द कॉन्सेप्ट वंस अगेन, हाउ डिड दे गेट टू नो दैट दे आर बेटर एंड दे शुड सिविलाइज अस व्हेन वी डू हैव आवर ओन स्ट्रॉन्ग रिलीजियस फेथ्स रूट्स एंड अ ग्रेट कल्चर. If we compare our culture to the culture of the Westerns, our culture is far better than their culture. हमारे पास तो हर दिन कुछ ना कुछ मनाने के लिए होता है. We are the people who believe in joint families, not the nuclear families. So culture is rich and better than them, these people. But then why these people made us follow their culture? उन्हें ऐसा क्यों लगा कि हम better हैं? ये लोग एकदम tribal हैं, इनको हम सिखाएंगे. साइंस तो नहीं बोल सकते, बट येस द फर्स्ट रेनेसां. सो दे आर द फर्स्ट पीपल, दे फाउंड अस. नो डाउट वी ऑल्सो हैड आवर रेनेसां, वी वर वेरी स्पिरिचुअल. व्हेन वी वर डीलिंग विद गॉड्स एंड गॉडेसेस, दे स्टार्टेड सर्चिंग द वर्ल्ड. सो प्रैक्टिकली दे बिकेम बेटर देन अस. दे फाउंड अस, दे रियलाइज दैट दे आर द पीपल फेवर्ड बाय गॉड. वो वाइट सुप्रीमेसी का कॉन्सेप्ट आ गया. उन्होंने लगा हम सबसे बेटर हैं, हमने दुनिया को देखा है और हम लोगों को एक बेहतर लाइफस्टाइल दे सकते हैं. दैट्स द कॉन्सेप्ट डेवलप्ड बाय रुडयार्ड किपलिंग, नोन एज व्हाइट मैन्स बर्डन. प्लीज मेंशन इट हियर, रुडयार्ड किपलिंग्स व्हाइट मैन्स बर्डन. रुडयार्ड किपलिंग व्हाइट मैन्स बर्डन. सो व्हाट इज द बर्डन? White man's burden, Kipling says that we are the white race, white people, superior race, and it is our burden. We have been burdened. God has given us a duty of reforming you. जब हम post-colonials पढ़ेंगे ना, there will be a theory, a term, ambivalence, relation between the colonizer and the colonized. So when we were crying that why are you forcing us to be like you? Why are you snatching all our properties, gold and minerals, raw material? You're taking it away. You're making us poor. आप हमें और गरीब बना रहे हो. Moreover, you're crushing our culture. You're forcing us to follow English language, forgetting our own religion, own culture, own language. They said, no, this is not an atrocity. ये कोई क्रूरता नहीं है. ये हमारी duty है. हम आपको पढ़ा लिखा के एक level पे लेके आ रहे हैं. What gave them this idea that they are better? उन्हें ये कैसे हो कि हम बेटर हैं? पावर. द वन हु हैज पावर इज राइट. अगर हमारे पास पावर होती, हम जाते हैं इंग्लैंड तो हम उन्हें बोलते कि होली दिवाली मनाओ, ईद मनाओ. सो दे थॉट दे आर बेटर, दे स्टार्टेड कंट्रोलिंग अस एंड द फर्स्ट कॉलोनाइजेशन रिजल्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ इंपीरियलिस्टिक एटीट्यूड्स, इंपीरियलिज्म. समटाइम्स पीपल क्वेश्चन दैट कैन वी से कॉलोनियलिज्म एंड इंपीरियलिज्म आर सेम. दे आर नॉट सेम. But colonialism in most of the cases results after imperialism. Imperialism is samrajyavad, jisme aapko sirf apni boundary badhani hoti hai. Imperialism is samrajyavad, where you take military power. Using the military power, you attack, you capture some land, you conquer some country, and then you force them to follow you psychologically, religiously, mentally. आपकी फिलॉसफी, आपके थॉट प्रोसेस, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर फॉलोड बाय देम. इंपीरियलिज्म देखो क्या है. इंपीरियलिज्म है साम्राज्यवाद. आपने किसी के घर पे जाके कब्जा कर लिया, आपने किसी के घर पे प्रॉपर्टी पे कब्जा कर लिया, दैट इज साम्राज्यवाद, दैट इज इंपीरियलिज्म. यू जस्ट अटैक्ड सम कंट्री, यू हैड अ बेटर मिलिट्री पावर, यू कॉन्कर्ड दैट कंट्री. नाउ यू हैव कॉन्कर्ड, सो व्हाट विल यू डू? You will plant your people there. You will ask them to follow your rules now. And that's how the colonization will start. Their school syllabus, their college syllabus will be changed according to you. which is known as colonial education. So colonization and imperialism are not same, but in maximum cases imperialism is the first step of colonization. जो imperialization है, imperialism है, वो पहला step होता है maximum cases में. Talking about World War One, World War Two, क्योंकि उस समय क्या था, military power use कर रहे थे. But can we say that present colonization is imperialistic colonization? No, it is economic colonization. जिसके पास ज़्यादा पैसा है, World Bank है, वो अपनी चलाएगा, ठीक है? Now the concept is that how the world got divided in two parts now. Why India, South Asia, we are known as the third world countries. How it got divided in East and West concept. So being the white race, the racial inequality, the white supremacy, it made all others, the browns, the blacks, the other ones. So the white one, hum, other ones, others. And if you remember William Shakespeare, Othello has been mentioned as an outsider. So why you use the word outsider? Means somebody who is not like us. That is known as us other mentality. Now let's understand what is us other mentality. So let's take an example. Again, easy example. We're all Indians here, right? Suppose we meet each other in London. Will we be happy having someone from our own country? A psychological comfort? अभी हम इंडिया के हैं, सपोज करो हम लंदन में मिलते हैं, हम दोस्त बन जाएंगे. बट वी गेट बैक टू इंडिया एंड यू आर फ्रॉम केरला, आई एम फ्रॉम कश्मीर, आर वी फ्रॉम सेम स्टेट, सेम कंट्री, सेम स्टेट? नो, वी आर लाइक, अरे यू हैव डिफरेंट फूड, आई हैव डिफरेंट फूड स्टाइल. सो टेक्निकली देर इज अ डिफरेंस, बट इन अब्रॉड वी बोथ विल बी लाइक, अरे हाँ दोनों इंडियन हैं. वॉट इफ वन इज एन इंडियन, वन इज अ पाकिस्तानी इन इंग्लैंड? Are they going to fight there or going to be the friends?
Friends.
Who will become us there?
Sir,
the Indians. And other kon ban jayega? The other one, the white ones. What if there is a Bangladeshi? He will also be the part of the us group, and the other ones will be white one. And the same thing, some American comes to you here, he is the one who is looking for his company, even if he finds another Western, a Britisher. The color, the white thing, and the concept of otherness will make them us. So they will be the us looking at the others, calling that you are different. So the basic difference is racial inequality. यहाँ से start हुआ. अब इसके बाद आपके economic जो हैं वो आएंगे issues. West and East का concept. If you remember, there is a famous line: East is East, West is West, and twain shall never meet. लिखो, बहुत अच्छी line. लिखो. जी बहुत बढ़िया. रुडयार्ड किपलिंग, 1907 नोबेल अवार्ड, ही हैज रिटन अ फेमस बैलेड. बैलेड इज अ लॉन्ग पोइट्री विच हैज अ स्टोरी. सो ही हैज रिटन अ फेमस बैलेड एंड द बैलेड सेज, ईस्ट इज ईस्ट, वेस्ट इज वेस्ट, ईस्ट इज ईस्ट, वेस्ट इज वेस्ट, एंड ट्वाइन, टी डब्ल्यू ए आई एन, एंड ट्वाइन शैल नेवर मीट. And twain shall never meet. He says, we are always better than you. We will be better than you. So east is east, west is west, and twain shall never meet. Means ye cheezein kabhi mix nahi hongi. Now going to give you another reference taken from NET exam. It comes from Passes to India. Dr. Aziz, after going through the legal proceedings and the false accusation of a rape charge, he meets Mr. Fielding again at the end of the story, and Mr. Fielding says, Dr. Aziz, we are still friends. Hum abhi bhi dost hain. And the reply of Dr. Aziz was the question of NET exam. What does he reply? He said, no, not here, not under that sky. Isko last line hai, likho. This is the last line of Passes to India. Passes to India ka last line hai, when Mr. Fielding says, Dr. Aziz, when Mr. Fielding says, Dr. Aziz, we are still friends. Dr. Aziz, we are still friends. Then Dr. Aziz replies, no, not here, not under that sky. No, not here, not under that sky. when Dr. Aziz and Mr. Fielding, they were friends first, but then Dr. Aziz was accused of rape charge, and Mr. Fielding, though he was a good man, but he did not stand for his defense. He didn't try to save him, not that much, not that effort. So he said, nahi, nahi. Dr. Aziz said, no, we are not friends. Not here, not under that sky means this change where you are the colonizers, we are the colonized ones. So there is a power structure. You are the powerful, we are the weaker one, and we cannot have any friendship. Famous writer from Sudan, Tayyab Salih. Write the name. Tayyab Salih, agar yaad rakhna, ek books mein nahi milta hai, market guide books mein. Tayyab Salih. In fact, aapke alawa net mein koi padhke nahi jayega. In Tayyab Salih's famous book, he comes from Sudan. The spelling is T-Y-E-B-S-A-L-I-H. He is a Sudanese writer. Sudan se hai, Sudan country, minor country hai. Tayyab Salih. And in his famous book, Seasons of the Migration to the North. Seasons of Migration to the North. His famous book, Seasons of Migration to the North. There is a character Mustafa. There is a character Mustafa. And he says, there is a line, Othello, there is no Othello. Othello was a lie. Othello, there is no Othello. He says Othello, he then takes a pause, ruk jata hai. Like he has emotions, he wants to say something. But then he says Othello, then takes a pause. There is no Othello. Othello was a lie. Now people, those who have no idea about this book will never understand what's the message here. He was very much fascinated with American concepts, American lifestyle. Even we people are. Hame bhi agar angrezon ke paas jaane ka mauka mile America, to kaun nahi jana chahega? Ab kabhi aisa hota hai ki aap Bharat ke kisi gaon mein ghoom ke aao aur khoob status lagao. Lekin aisa zarur hoga agar aap Europe chale jao to 500-600 status laga sakte ho. That's the difference. This is exotic otherness, curiosity. Ye aapko padhaunga us term mein. So he thought that he'll be respected in America, he'll be favored in America, but he found that in America he was just an other person, someone who is an outsider, and that's why, being heartbroken, ab uska dil toot gaya, he says, nahi, koi Othello nahi hai. Othello was a lie. Why he takes the message of Othello, reference of Othello? Because Othello was an outsider, loved by a white lady, respected by the Duke, and had his own identity in Western country. So he was very much inspired. Ki agar Othello the black, Othello the Moor, use ek white lady pasand kar sakti hai, it means there is no racial inequality. King use Duke bana sakta hai, commander bana sakta hai. He was a commander. It means they respect our talent and I can find my identity. But then this illusion, he was totally in, a kind of bhram, usme wo illusion mein tha. He went there, it got broken. He realized that there is nothing like that. So the basic difference of postcolonial concept is us and other mentality. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, we're going to talk about this important thing. How the world got colonized and what are the ways of colonization. So, isko point mein note kar lo. The ways they have colonized. The basic styles of colonization. From literary point of view, we'll see. Like, how do you colonize someone? So the very first thing is imperialism. Pehle to you have guns and you point at someone and make them do. So you are the one who has the gun in the house. So obviously you are the ruler. You are going to set the trend. So the very first thing, first step of colonization is power, imperialism. So first thing, if you have power, you can do anything. Yeah, military power, the very first thing. Angrej aasani se nahi aaye the. They came here, they understood, they called army. I came, I saw, I conquered. Winnie Vidi Vici. Sir Thomas Rowe, he was the first man to come in the Darbar of Jahangir. They studied and they wrote letters to their people. Are these people are fighting for religion. None of them trust anyone. Let's fight and let's make them fight. Army aagayi wapas. I came, I saw, I observed, and I conquered. This happened there. Now, first thing is imperialism. Let's apply this in Africa. The African colonization was far easier, a better thing than Indian colonization. ये क्वेश्चन है जीनियो का कि इंडिया को कॉलोनाइज करना आसान था या अफ्रीका को कॉलोनाइज करना आसान था. व्हाट डू यू थिंक, अफ्रीका को कॉलोनाइज करना आसान है या इंडिया को? यस, इट्स
अफ्रीका.
ओके, होल्ड ऑन होल्ड ऑन, इट्स वेरी इजी आंसर, बट आपको सिर्फ बुक्स के रेफरेंस के साथ जाना है. इट्स अफ्रीका विच वॉज वेरी इजी टू कॉलोनाइज. जी, पॉवर्टी इंडिया में भी थी. देखो, पॉवर्टी, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इश्यूज, करप्शन आर एट द डिफरेंट साइड. वन थिंग इज द डिफरेंट साइड, रिलीजन. पुअर से पुअर पर्सन, रिच से रिच पर्सन अपने गॉड के पास जाते हैं, हाथ जोड़ते हैं. इंडिया हैड थ्री बिग रिलीजन्स, हिंदुइज्म, इस्लाम, सिखिज्म, एंड ऑल दीज थ्री रिलीजन्स आर वेरी रिच इन देयर कल्चर, इन देयर डॉक्ट्रिन्स. सबके बहुत अच्छे सिद्धांत हैं, कोई भी ऐसा कमजोर वीक पॉइंट नहीं है. सो इट वॉज नॉट ईजी फॉर देम टू मेक अस फॉरगेट इस्लाम, मेक अस फॉरगेट हिंदुइज्म, सिखिज्म एंड एक्सेप्ट क्रिश्चियनिटी. इट्स नॉट दैट ईजी फॉर देम. सो दे मेड अस लीव आवर लैंग्वेज फर्स्ट, दे इंट्रोड्यूस अस टूवर्ड्स द वेस्टर्न एक्सॉटिक लाइफ स्टाइल. बट इन अफ्रीका इट वॉज ईजी. अफ्रीका वॉज डिवाइडेड इन थाउजेंड्स ऑफ विलेजेस, सब ट्राइबल्स थे. There was no state, no country, and the tribals, they had 300 to 500 people in a village. It was easy to kill them, it was easy to force them to follow, and moreover, they were totally illiterate, there was no strong religion. If you read African literature, you'll find out that most of the people, they thought that these trees are gods, then these kind of, what do you call, cockroaches are gods, then spiders are gods. वो इनको भगवान मानते हैं, उनके blind faith थे. तो it was very easy for them. And what did they do there? They used power. Kill the priest, become the head of the village. Most of the villages, they had these rules that if you are capable of defeating the head of the village in a punch fight, in a fist fight, you'll be the head. वो बंदूक ले जाते थे, गोली मार देते थे, बात खत्म. And then 300 लोगों को force करना आसान है, लाखों लोगों को. So that's how they were all forced to go for Christianity. If you have read Chinua Achebe's Things Fall Apart, when Okonkwo comes back, he says, why these people are going for Christianity when Mr. Brown, he's the one who's the missionary there. So another old man says, our youth is crazy after them. Our youth are, they're following them. They want to be like them because they also introduce the exotic otherness. Now how it changes your mindset. अब हम बात करते हैं कि आपको जब एक बार colonize किया, पावर यूज किया. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ब्रिटिश राज, दैट्स हाउ दे यूज पावर. सेकेंड स्टेप है, दे किल योर लैंग्वेज, द इजिएस्ट वे, बट इट्स नॉट दैट ईजी, इट टेक्स वेरी लॉन्गर टाइम. सेकेंड थिंग इज किल द लैंग्वेज. इट्स अ स्टेटमेंट बाय गुगिवो थियोंगो, राइट दैट. गुगिवो थियोंगो का स्टेटमेंट है, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू किल द कल्चर, किल द लैंग्वेज फर्स्ट. गुगिवो थियोंगो, एन जी यू आई जी यू जी आई W. A. War Thiong'o, his famous work Black Hermit, The River Between. Yes, वो भी है. Now, Gugiwo Thiong'o, his famous statement is, he says, if you want to kill the culture, kill the language first. The moment you forget your language, you start ignoring your own language, there are many things, many roots, deep structures related to your language only. Gugiwo Thiong'o, G-U-G-I, ये रहा यहाँ पे, this is the spelling, G-U-G-I, W-A, Wa, Thiong'o, Black Hermit. We'll be completing him as an African writer, separately African literature while we're teaching you. Here he is very important because what did he say? To kill the culture, kill the language first. Now remember, in 1833 and 35 minutes of Macaulay, Macaulay stated the same thing, that India is very rich in its culture, in its religion, and we have to make them understand that we are far better than them, and by teaching them English language, we can make them read our literature, we can make them follow us, and later they will realize that they are actually inferior. Usne bola tha, and he said that my dream will come true, and that will be my biggest achievement, the day Indians take English as the only language they can have. कहा कि जिस दिन ऐसा होगा ना कि उनको एक ही लैंग्वेज दिखाई देगी, द डे दे विल ट्राई टू बी लाइक अस, दैट विल बी माय बिगेस्ट अचीवमेंट. एंड आज मैकॉले जीत चुका है, लॉर्ड मैकॉले. उसने कहा था मैं उस दिन जीतूंगा, उस दिन बिगेस्ट सक्सेस होगी जिस दिन ईच एंड एवरी इंडियन विल ट्राई टू लर्न इंग्लिश, विल ट्राई, विल बिकम क्रेजी फॉर इंग्लिश लाइफ स्टाइल, इंग्लिश थिंग्स. और ये हो गया है मैकॉले. क्या भाई, कौन मैकॉले के लिए क्लैप कर रहा है? डोंट डू दैट, मैकॉले के लिए मत करो. ही डिड हिज ड्यूटी, वो जिसको जो काम मिला था उसने काम किया. नाउ सी दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, गुगीवो थियोंगो हैज रिटन अ फेमस एसे डीकॉलोनाइजिंग द माइंड. गो फॉर इट, डीकॉलोनाइजिंग द माइंड. सो वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस थिंग, द लैंग्वेज कॉन्सेप्ट. डीकॉलोनाइजिंग द माइंड डील्स विद द लैंग्वेज कॉन्सेप्ट. डीकॉलोनाइज करना, लाभ किसी को फ्री करना. सो आवर माइंड्स आर कॉलोनाइज्ड, लेट्स फ्री इट, लेट्स रिलीज द स्पेस एंड सो दैट वी कैन हैव मोर स्पेस. सो एम्प्टी करना उसको, डीकॉलोनाइज द माइंड. सो डीकॉलोनाइजिंग द माइंड, दैट्स द वर्क. एंड हियर ही सेज इंग्लिश डिपार्टमेंट्स इन इंडिया एंड अफ्रीका एंड अदर कॉलोनाइज कंट्रीज. बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट लाइन है, ध्यान से सुनना. वो कहता है जितनी भी कॉलोनाइज कंट्रीज हैं, ऑल द कॉलोनाइज कंट्रीज दे हैव इंग्लिश डिपार्टमेंट्स. I was teaching in University of Delhi, Department of English. English departments are working as agents and they're still colonizing us. He said to decolonize these countries completely, we must eliminate all those things. We must sweep these things away. हमको ये सारे English departments बंद करवाने पड़ेंगे. आप सब English agents हो, मैं भी वही हूँ. And what he says, like what are we doing? English teacher padha rahe hain dusre ko. We are continuing that thing. We are continuing the colonization. Aap yahan 250 something ho. Aap 250 universities mein chale jao. Wahan pe padhaoge. So the Department of English are actually working as agents. He said, in sab ko khatam karo. These things should be wiped out. Pehle to inko khatam karo. Otherwise, kabhi mind khali nahi hoga. And second thing he said, avoid the language. Do not use the language of colonizers. This is known as abrogation. इसे एब्रोगेशन बोलते हैं. प्लीज राइट द टर्म, पोस्ट कॉलोनियल टर्म है एब्रोगेशन. एब्रोगेशन इज अ नोन रेसिस्टेंस. व्हेन यू नो द थिंग्स, अ नोन रेसिस्टेंस, अ रेसिस्टेंस वेयर योर विल इज इन्वॉल्व, नोइंगली यू आर रेसिस्टिंग समथिंग. एब्रोगेशन व्हेन यू नोइंगली डू समथिंग जस्ट टू रेसिस्ट द कॉलोनाइजेशन. ट्राई दैट, मैंने किया है, बड़ा मजा आता है. एंड costly restaurants in 5 stars in South Delhi or top malls, yeah, you go to the airports, speak in Hindi. Try kiya kabhi kisi ne? English aane ke baad bhi Hindi bol ke dekhiye. If you compare India's bus stand and India's airport, people, those who are at the bus stand will speak in Hindi even if they know English. And people at the airport will try to speak in English even if they don't know English. And trust me, reading post-colonials, मैंने इतना, I really feel bad, बहुत बुरा लगता है, सच में कई बार तो इतना बुरा लगता है ना, कि why, क्या artificial acting कर रहे हो यार. I can tell you, I was in the flight, so we were in like 12th and 13th number seat, ऐसा कुछ होता है कि flight attendant, she'll come to you, and she'll be like, sir, this is the special seat, so if something happens, will you be able to open the gate? So it's a kind of 1 minute briefing. She came and she was like blah 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 in English. She blabbered like anything. Sir, in the case of emergency, will you be able to blah, 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 blah. And trust me, I could not understand. Itna samajh mein aaya ki in the case of emergency, and I understood ki gate khulne ki baat hai. So there was a family behind me. So she was like, speak again. So she was like, ma'am, in the case of emergency, that way, okay. And she was like, ma'am, are you comfortable in English or should I tell you in Hindi? Nahi, nahi, only English. I was like, Hindi mein poochho bhaiya. Agar plane gira na, aur tum confused hoge grammar mein. Ki yaar, samajh nahi aa raha, ek word angrezi mein bola tha, kahan se khulta hai. To hum saare jayenge. Kam se kam wahan to, nahi, nahi, only English. What is that only English? Tumhe nahi samajh mein aa raha, bol do na Hindi mein, yaar, sunna hai. तो मैंने जानबूझ के उनको बोला, मैं मैम हिंदी में बोल दीजिए एक बार. अब उनकी हिंदी भी अंग्रेजी होती है. किसी भी आपात परिस्थिति में मैंने कहा सीधा बोल दो ना कि अगर गिर रहा है तो कहां से खोलना है, सोशल एक्ट पे जाओ ना जो समझ में आए. तो नहीं, उसने बोला, उन्होंने बोला कि नहीं सर दिस इज आवर लैंग्वेज. चलो वो अपनी जगह सही है, बट वाई वी आर सो मच आफ्टर दिस एंग्लोफिलिया कॉन्सेप्ट, सो मच फैसिनेटेड विद दिस थिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाट ही सेज, एब्रोगेट करो, अवॉइड दीज थिंग्स, नोइंगली हिंदी बोलो, नोइंगली अपनी लैंग्वेज बोलो. एंड ही वॉज द फर्स्ट राइटर हु स्टार्टेड राइटिंग इन हिज नेटिव लैंग्वेज गिकुयू, क्वेश्चन एंड नेट एग्जाम का. इन्होंने गुगियो थियोंगो स्टार्टेड राइटिंग इन हिज नेटिव लैंग्वेज गिकुयू. Remember that he started writing in Gikuyu. उन्होंने अपनी नेटिव लैंग्वेज में लिखना शुरू कर दिया. जी GIKUYU 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 Gikuyu. So he is the one who abrogated. Abrogation is a known resistance. So next time if you go for a coffee, you talk to them in Hindi. No doubt you will have to go through various type of emotions and gestures and expressions. We will show you these expressions. But still respect that thing. Clear? Second thing ho gaya. First imperialism, second language. Third, cultural imperialism. Cultural imperialism. Now the cultural imperialism, again a concept developed by Edward Said. Cultural imperialism. Cultural imperialism is not possible without the regular imperialism. You cannot influence someone with your culture. You must need power with you. You should have power. Cultural imperialism, force them to follow your culture. Force them to follow your culture. And now it's not that easy to force. So yahan pe kya hoga? Make them psychologically follow your cultures. So how will it become easy? It will be very easy if you have colonized them, you have controlled their language, introduce your culture to them. Apna culture introduce kar do. And this is happening. Ab to top jagah pe ho, Delhi mein ho. To aapko pata hoga yahan kitne western culture celebrate kiye jaate hain. Aur Halloween jaisi cheez gaon mein suni nahi hoti hai. How many of you know Halloween kya hota hai? No, I should say how many of you don't know what is Halloween? जब मैं भी 3-4 साल पहले तक मुझे नहीं पता था, मैंने इतने पूछा, मैंने क्या होता तो पता चला. So Halloween is some kind of celebration where you have to color your face or cover your face, and it's not our celebration. You should look like devil, right? उसमें devil बन के घूमना होता है ऐसा कुछ. So these are the masses that if you are the power structure, if you are the stronger one, you have colonized the language, control the language, they'll follow you. Clear? जी. नहीं नहीं, एब्रोगेशन कॉन्सेप्ट है, उन्होंने उसको एडवोकेट किया है. नाउ लिसन, आफ्टर दिस यू हैव कंट्रोल देयर कल्चर, यू हैव कंट्रोल देयर लैंग्वेज एंड यू हैव कंट्रोल देयर बाउंड्रीज. इंपीरियलिज्म, लैंग्वेज एंड कल्चर, द कॉलोनाइजेशन इज डन. नाउ देयर आर मेनी अदर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स, लाइक यू गो फॉर कॉलोनियल एजुकेशन. सो द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज कॉलोनियल एजुकेशन. नाउ यू हैव कॉलोनाइज्ड देम, यू हैव कंट्रोल्ड देम, एंड यू ऑल्सो कंट्रोल देयर कॉलेजेस, देयर यूनिवर्सिटी सिलेबस. What kind of syllabus are you going to let them read and analyze? Now you are the one who is the colonizer. और आपने क्या पढ़ाएंगे? My master, thou has taught me a tongue. Now I know how to curse you. Who says this? किस में कहता है? Tempest में कहता है. बोलता है, my master, thou has taught me a tongue. सिखाया तो आपने ही है. आपने सिखाया है. That's why I know how to react. Now I know how to curse you. Calvin says in Tempest. So what if the colonizers know it now? That teach them, but not that much. The Butler English concept. Question jo aapka net mein aaya tha, Butler English, also known as Babu English. The English in India was initially introduced for the servants and clerks. Yaad rakhiyega. Jab Madras Presidency ne Butler English ko promote kiya. Madras Presidency promoted Butler English. The clerical Calcutta Presidency promoted clerical English, which is also known as Babu English. So when English language was introduced in India, it was only for clerks and the servants in kitchen, known as Babu English. They say, if you go in the words of Salman Rushdie, we call it chutneyfication. where you mix up English and Hindi language, there is a word chutneyfication. Please write it. Chutneyfication, mixing Hindi, English, another slang words jo bhi aap mix kar sakte ho. Chutneyfication. It's a term by Salman Rushdie. Gee, imagine homeland me. So hold on. As told you, the Babu English concept, colonial education me, the clericals, the attendants, the servants, the chauffeurs, drivers, they were given some basic language lectures to understand the orders. So unhe English bola jata tha pehle, Hindi and English. And thanks to Salman Rushdie has given a very different word, chutneyfication, you'll remember it. Now, in imaginary homelands has this reference of chutneyfication. Imaginary homelands written by Salman Rushdie, please write this. Ye bhi net ke questions mein se hai. Imaginary homelands. Abhi we are still in British Raj, we are dealing with colonization. Then we'll go for post-colonials, ki hua kya uske baad, what are the laws? हमारे जो नुकसान है वो क्या है. सलमान रश्दी इन हिज इमेजिनरी होमलैंड्स टॉक्स अबाउट द कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर. चटनीफिकेशन मेंशनड है वो लिख लो, प्लीज राइट दैट. चटनीफिकेशन मेंशनड है कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर. नाउ रिमेंबर दैट कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट इज वन ऑफ हिज एसेज. सो मेक श्योर यू राइट दैट कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट इज एन एसे रिटन बाय सलमान रश्दी आज इन दिसंबर 2012 नेट एग्जाम में आ चुका है. ये Commonwealth literature does not exist. Commonwealth literature does not exist.
That's an essay.
It's an essay dealing with Commonwealth literature. Isko likh lo, then I'll tell you something very important. Commonwealth literature does not exist. Salman Rushdie. Inka ek aur acha aaya tha. We are all translated man. Wo bhi likh lo. We are all translated man. Another question in NET exam. हाँ, वी आर ये इसी का लाइन है. वी आर ऑल ट्रांसलेटेड मैन. इमेजिनरी होमलैंड्स में वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द आइडेंटिटीज एक्चुअली. सो वी आर ऑल ट्रांसलेटेड मैन. देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन व्हाट डज रश्दी वांट टू से इन वी आर ऑल ट्रांसलेटेड मैन. वी आर ऑल ट्रांसलेटेड मैन. सो आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस ऑल्सो. लाइन है, लाइन इट्स अ कोट. इमेजिनरी होमलैंड्स, इमेजिनरी होमलैंड्स में लाइन है वी आर ऑल ट्रांसलेटेड मैन. नाउ प्लीज शो द कैमरा टू द स्टूडेंट्स. वो वहां करना सामने, उधर घुमा दो. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव रेड एंड प्रिपेयर्ड कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर इन योर अंडर ग्रेजुएशन पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन. कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर आपकी कितनी यूनिवर्सिटी में पढ़ाया गया है? रेज योर हैंड्स. ओके, हमने भी पढ़ा था. अभी बहुत सी यूनिवर्सिटीज में चेंज हो गया, बट आप में से कुछ लोगों ने पढ़ा है. नाउ रिमेंबर दैट कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर कॉन्सेप्ट इज फिनिश्ड नाउ. सो नेवर एवर गो फॉर सम बुक्स लाइक कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर की बुक दे दो, नोट्स दे दो, ये सब मत करना किसी से. अर्लियर फॉर पोस्ट कॉलोनियल्स ओनली कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर वर्ड वर यूज एंड कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर स्टैंड्स फॉर द लिटरेचर कमिंग फ्रॉम द कॉलोनाइज कंट्रीज अंडर द रूल ऑफ ब्रिटेन. जी, कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर स्टैंड्स फॉर द लिटरेचर रिटन इन इंग्लिश. कॉमनवेल्थ लिटरेचर स्टैंड्स फॉर literature written in English by the countries which were once colonized, by the countries which were once colonized by Britain. The literature written by the British colonies, simple. Commonwealth literature is literature written by the British colonies.